Hello and welcome to the non-Greg Strelis show, except only the substitutes. I'm your host, the Pamazon. I'm a little dusty. I was working on my house and then came straight here. Probably have stuff on me, but it's okay. Yeah, except only the substitutes. And we have also here, who else? The Jonazon.
Oh, hi. I think looking at it on the screen, I tried trimming my beard. I think it looks pretty good.
Yes.
I tried to go for that Darren Malakian look, but I can't do his because Darren Malakian seems to have a literal neck beard. Like, he only has the hair on his like neck, but like it looks cool on him. But I guess I was trying to do like maybe him combined with Serge. I mean, nobody knows what I'm talking about, but
no, nobody does.
Hey, it's the Dud Duds.
Of course it is. Who else would be here?
Yeah, we knocked some stuff over. I'm sorry. We were taking photos up here and then practicing.
Well,
sorry, Dud Duds.
Well, Dudley is...
I got a little tipsy myself.
He's a famous young man.
Even yeah, I don't know where those creepy onions, those really gross onions went, the onion jam.
It's great that those are gone. Now we just gotta get rid of these.
Those are gross. They've...
with the candy corns.
They like
in them.
Just become like powdery. They don't even look real. It looks so gross.
I don't know why you have to keep them by me.
Well, yeah, that's fair.
We probably should throw them away.
Yeah, I shouldn't even have bought it. I just because I didn't.
Oh, it was funny. Someone said they were gonna eat it, and then yeah, it didn't happen. And
it's just gross. Even if it's the most high quality chocolate with the most high quality
candy corn,
it's still disgusting. But you know, that's just some garbage like crud they had left over or something.
That's true. That is true. True, true, true.
Yeah, I don't know. But yeah, I think it trimmed pretty good, but. I also have been looking, I really like sports clothes a lot, even though I don't really like sports, and I've really been wanting an Oilers jersey lately, but I found them up, I've been looking them up on Facebook Marketplace, the cheapest ones I can find are still like 30 bucks.
Huh.
I love the Oilers jerseys. I like the old Sabres jerseys too. Hockey jerseys just look cool. I mean, I like sports clothes, even though I don't really like sports, especially like, I love soccer shirts, I love hockey jerseys. I like baseball shirts. I don't care at all about football shirts or basketball. To me, those are too, like, sporty. But rugby, soccer, hockey.
I'm trying to sit in a way to cover.
I'm hoping if I run into, like, an Oilers
stuff
jersey
on me
at, like, a thrift store.
That would be nice.
I don't know. I just
They're probably hard to come by because people probably buy them and then resell them.
Yeah, probably. Plus, it's a Canadian... Well, it's a Canadian team, so they're not as common here.
Yeah.
I've seen them play many times, but I didn't. I was forced to go to many, many hockey games. But I don't really care about the actual sport that much. It's funny because Tiny Tim actually is obsessed with hockey. He loved hockey for some reason. He always wore hockey jerseys. He always wore the Maple Leafs, though.
The only hockey games I ever went to are ones I was photographing, and I think I mentioned this before. It's very terrifying because, you aren't, the glass is not protecting you while you're photographing it. So if you get hit, you know.
No, it's scary. I mean, I was in the front row many times. I've seen people get hit with pucks and stuff.
Have you? How'd they get through the glass?
Well, there's not always glass there.
Oh.
Certain areas, at least.
Oh, okay.
Or it'll just fly over it.
Oh, wow.
I mean, I've gotten pucks that way. Like, they would just fly over and somebody would give it to me.
Mm.
Most of it's covered with glass, but there's sections that aren't, and there's sections where it just flies over. I mean, hockey's crazy. But yeah, it's very funny that Tiny Tim liked hockey, considering he's, like, the least sporty, athletic person ever.
Yeah, what is Oliver doing?
Yeah, we hear Oliver having a fit somewhere downstairs.
Maybe you should go check on him real quick, or you want me to check on him real quick?
You can check on him if you want. I don't move very slow because I'm having...
Yeah, I know. You got the. There's a horrible stomach flu going around. Don't try not to catch it. It's kind of a stinker. I mean, it's not that horrible, but it's no fun.
It's true. But I also, yeah.
I've definitely had worse
Peppy,
stomach flu. Let me go see what he's doing.
Yeah, he's a... Sorry. Yeah, well, yeah. I like soccer jerseys because I feel like soccer jerseys are very colorful, and I feel like they have cool patterns and stuff. Basketball is so lame looking. Like, I hate basketball jerseys. Like, the only person who I know who likes basketball jerseys that I still think is cool is, like, Buckethead. But, like, he's also, like, you know, 7 foot whatever. So he's huge. So, he can play basketball and just, like, immediately win. I mean, yeah, he's a big guy. I mean, yeah, I don't know. I really like the soccer ones especially. I feel like they feel the best and they have the coolest colors. Like, I found a cool Brazilian soccer jersey. And my dad gave me really cool soccer jerseys from when he was in Brazil in the early 80s that are really cool. I remember I was at Jim's Steakout on Elmwood and this dude offered me like $500 on the spot for it plus his own shirt, so I didn't have to go without one. But it's just too cool looking. What was he doing? Sorry, Oliver is coming. Was he just being his crazy self?
So the minute I went down there and said his name, he went quiet, of course. Because obviously he was probably trying to do something bad. And then I found him hiding because he was obviously doing something bad.
That's the way of the Oliver.
It is. It is the way of the Oliver.
Yeah, I don't know why. I don't know why I was discussing sports clothes. I just really like sports clothes.
We try and cover. There we go.
Soccer jerseys, I have to think, have the best fabric. They feel so good.
Okay.
But I don't. The two I really just don't care about. I just don't like football and I don't like basketball. But I know I keep reiterating, but it's true. They're just the worst ones. Baseball's also very nice and silky feeling.
Well, I've got nothing to say about sports jerseys. I'm not much of a sports jersey fan.
That's okay.
Yeah, they're not really my thing, so to speak.
That's okay. I mean, I'm just kind of surprising that I even like. But I do, especially the soccer and the hockey. But I don't know, whatever. I'm just going over nonsense that nobody cares about. But, that's... I don't know. How many Buffalo teams are there? Let's see. There's the Buffalo...
I have no idea.
There's the Buffalo Bandits. There's the Buffalo... what's the one? They sponsor Rachel's, the female... football team.
You're asking the wrong person. We have a female football team?
Yeah.
I can't remember what
they're called, though.
Come on. We do not. You're making that up.
No, I do. they're always on the Rachel's bags. Okay, we have the Sabres, obviously. We have the Bisons. We did
have
no
idea.
Toronto Blue Jays. I think they're just called, like, America or something. Let me look this up.
John, you're making it up.
Buffalo female football team.
Quit making shit up, John.
He's totally making it up.
He is.
Here we go. That's not the one. Where is it? I know it's because they're always on the Rachel's bags. Because I was like, what team is this? I don't recognize them. Okay, here. Whatever, it doesn't matter. I'll find it later.
No, find it now. We want the proof.
All right.
I want the proof.
I'll find. I'm looking. Okay, well. Find the Rochester ones, the Lady Lancers. What's the Buffalo one?
Lady Lancers?
Yeah.
That sounds kind of gross. Sounds like they're lancing boils and stuff.
Okay, here we go. FC Buffalo.
FC Buffalo?
Yeah.
What does that even stand for?
Let's see.
That's a lame name.
It doesn't say what it stands for.
FC Buffalo?
Yeah. FC Buffalo.
Ready.
I knew it was something like that. But yeah, I remember seeing their logo on the Rachel's bags. Like all the other ones I recognized, but I did not recognize that one.
Happy.
But we've also got we got the Bandits. We've got them. We've got the Bills, of course. We've got we have a bunch of soccer teams. I don't know. Who cares? I don't know why I'm even talking about. I don't like sports. But.
You were showing what a sports in town we are here.
It is definitely a very sports enthusiast town. I mean, I was just forced to go to so many sporting events because my dad made the ice at the arena, and he also like was one of the main people who mowed the lawn at the baseball stadium. So I was there all the time. But I mostly enjoyed when getting to go see the circus and stuff. That was way cooler.
Did you get to see the circus?
Oh, I saw the circus so many times.
Oh, well, that's nice.
That was way cooler. Like, there was, I remember all those clowns on those motorcycles. That was crazy. They were like flying upside down and stuff. Oh, I remember the one time the one guy kept trying for like 20 minutes to do like the trapeze act, and he kept falling, and they're like, let's give him one more try, folks. And then eventually just like, okay, let's move on. It's like, damn, you might want to like learn how to do that before you go out and do the circus. Although sadly, Barnum and Bailey had its last circus a couple years ago. They shut it down.
But wow, how long did that go for?
Since like the 1850s or something.
Wow.
Yeah, I saw them relatively recently, like, you know, 5 or 6 years ago or something. I mean, there's smaller circuses, but I don't know. I just like the circus. I like seeing all the crazy, like, tricks and stuff and all the clowns. And it was kind of crazy. Like, they didn't really have the animals so much. They did have elephants at the one time. But other than that, it was mostly just, like, them doing crazy tricks. Like, I remember they had, like, these, like, tiny people just, like, doing all these crazy, like, stacking and stuff. I don't know. I'd have to look it up. I used to like going to the circus. I'm trying to think of other things I saw at the arena that was actually fun. But for the most part, I just remember liking the circus.
Hmm.
I mean, other than that. I mean, I remember seeing some, like, ice skating competitions, which is more fun than regular hockey.
Ice skating competitions?
Like, figure skating.
Figure skating, okay.
I mean, that was at least kind of cool. I didn't know anything about it. I remember I got dragged to some lame WWF thing, which is so lame. I mean, it would only have been cool if it was like the Iron Sheik or something, but I think I literally fell asleep for that. Like, wrestling is, it's so boring.
I've been to a boxing match. I photographed it.
Boxing seems more interesting because at least it's like genuine.
It was funny because this one boxer came out and he was all schlubby, but he'd been in like an Olympic boxer, and then out comes this real muscular dude. I'm like, oh man, that guy, the Olympic guy's gonna get whooped, and he made such quick work of the other guy. It was just like bam, 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 done. And the look on the guy's face when he was on the ground, he was just like, what the?
Trying to find all the other, because I know there was like another one on Rachel's Bags. That like there was like a bunch of sports teams on the Rachel's Bags, and I can't remember all.
Why are they on the Rachel's Bags? They sponsor them, I guess.
I assume so, or like,
yeah.
I don't know. I have to find a Rachel's Bag. But Rachel's, if you don't know, is really good. It's like, I don't think enough people like even know about Rachel's. It's, I mean, I feel like they're starting to.
I heard them on the radio being advertised. So that's something.
It's picking up. Rachel's is like, I think it's the best buffalo chain we have by far. I mean, Mighty Taco's more famous, but it's like, come on, Rachel's is way better. I mean, it is. And unless Alibaba Kebab takes off as a chain, which it's starting to, then
I think that they are. Aren't they opening somewhere else?
Yeah, they are.
Where are they opening?
On Hurdle.
On Hurdle?
That's what I said.
Oh. Well, lucky people on Hurdle. So tasty. Yum, yum, yum.
It is very good.
And they give you a lot of points when you buy food there, too.
Yeah, they definitely do.
Like, we got, like, how much? Like, $50 worth of food for free?
Like, twice in a row.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah, I still have my own account when I got a bunch of points on there, too. But yeah, I finally managed to get Andy to try something from there. He was so skeptical, but he did like those cheese kebabs.
Why was he skeptical?
Because he's like, why is it a website? Like, what?
I know. Alibabakebab.com. That's what they always say when you call.
Yeah. And I think he's just, because like, it used to be this joke, we'd go buy it. That we'd be like, it's a physical website? Like, what does that mean?
No, I remember
you must enter a password before you come in.
Do you accept cookies? And they literally have like a plate of cookies.
I remember driving past it, and I had been looking at it online and looking at pictures, and I'm like, oh, that looks so yummy. And then finally one day I just pulled in and I ordered food, and I was like, oh my goodness, so good.
Yeah, they're really good. They have a lot of stuff too. They have like different kinds of fish and chicken and stuff.
Last time they didn't have my favorite fish. That made me sad. Oh well.
Oh, they don't have it anymore?
I don't know if they just ran out or what. you know.
I had an issue with that fish. I liked it, but literally the second it would touch my tongue, it made me like feel like I had to throw up. I don't know why.
How do you like it, but it makes you feel like you're going to throw up?
Because I feel like that's it's something that like physically occurs where it makes it me sick. Huh. Not that I dislike it, you know. It's like you could
I don't understand that. It's so weird. I'm trying to think if I've ever...
I mean, somebody could be allergic to something, but they still like how it tastes.
I remember... Actually, when I was a kid in the school cafeteria, like the food looked so, so bad that I had to close my eyes and then eat it because I couldn't look at it and eat it. Maybe it's something like that.
I mean, you obviously like bread and beer and stuff, even though you can't really eat it.
No, it's true. I can't really eat it.
Yeah, I don't know what it is about that. It used to be that way with the hard apple cider, too. I don't know why. Like, I liked how it tastes, but literally the second I took a sip, I would immediately puke. Every time. Eventually, I stopped. That stopped happening, but for a long time, even just single
That's
sip,
so
I would
crazy.
Immediately puke.
What?
I don't know why.
That's kind of crazy that you kept trying it.
Because it tasted so good. I'm like, all right, I'm just going to, like, force it. Like, whatever.
I can't really, I don't know.
They were just, I mean, I still like that. I can't really drink anymore right now, but I do, those are just so sugary.
They are sugary.
I mean, I guess it's just pure, like, fruit juice, basically, but I used to like the pear one more than the apple one, but it was harder to find. But I just like pears.
We're talking about the Ukraine stuff.
Who?
People are, you know, they're worried about Russia and Ukraine. And
it's very bad.
It's very worrisome.
Good reason to. I mean, yeah, I don't know. There's so many other post-Soviet places that who knows what like they'll do on top of it, you know.
In addition, you mean like Latvia?
Just like in general, like that they might want. I mean, you know, so much of my family came from the Soviet Union, but well, like I said, at the time it was in the Soviet Union.
Armenia, you mean?
Yeah.
It's still not really the Soviet Union, though.
It was the Soviet Union.
Well, it's not now, though, right?
No, I'm just saying at the time.
Yeah.
No, when they left, I guess it was pre-Soviet, still, but. Yeah, Soviet Armenia was weird because, like, they didn't really want to be part of the Soviet Union, but they were so, like, I think they suffered, like, the worst out of any Soviet state. Like, they had, like, nothing. There's so many crazy stories about how, like, they only had electricity, like, 3 days out of the week and only for certain hours, and they had, like, no food. It seemed like it was so crappy. But that's a weird little country. It's, like, it's just bizarre. Then you got, like, Arkesh, which is, like, other Armenia, which is even more weird, but I don't know, nobody cares.
I have been to Belarus, so which is not officially the Soviet Union, but it's pretty much the Soviet Union still, as they are aiding the Soviet Union right now, and they're poor. I don't know how they can tolerate any sanctions. They're really poor.
Yeah, I would imagine. They're fascinating. If you look up them, like, speaking their own language and trying to, like, reclaim their own original language. And I always bring it up, which is fascinating how so many of them, like, don't want to be associated with Russia because they have so much of, like, a history before it with their own, like, writing system and stuff, which is kind of cool. Kind of like Kazakhstan. Like, Kazakhstan, they forced them to switch to Cyrillics, even though originally Kazakhstan only wrote in Arabic script. So now they kind of are trying to go back to the Arabic script after being forced to use... Like, Armenia never switched over to the Cyrillics. They always just used their own script, but a lot of places did. It's kind of crazy. Again, I was going to the same territory. Cartoons, scripts, just, like, the most boring crap.
You do like certain territories. Hey, another fun thing. This is probably something Dudley might like to know. Our favorite ice cream place is open.
Oh, yeah, that's true. We tried going, sadly. We were only, like, a minute late.
The corner.
The corner is open. The best custard in town at the corner. So good.
It's true.
It is true. And we still haven't managed to get over there.
Yeah, I know. I was thinking about it today, and then I forgot. They are. The corner is definitely by far the best, I think, as far as that kind of thing. I mean, there's other places that I like. I miss Mr. Freeze, or whatever it was called. Mr. Cool.
Major Cool.
Major Cools.
Was it Major Cool-Off?
Oh, yeah, that's right. They were
really
good.
That's a great name, Major Cool-Off.
They said...
so weird.
Temporary shutdown, but I think they're just gone.
Well, now isn't there like a smoke place or some shit there?
Oh, yeah, now it's just like a weed store. But...
doesn't seem so temporary. Where are you trying to go, you little bad thing?
I mean, I don't... You know, obviously, I remember the owners, like, meeting them. They were, like, really super happy they owned it. I mean, they were really... You know, they really enjoyed it. So I feel like they didn't want it closed, and they probably just
COVID there was came. Always people there, yeah, when COVID came, I guess.
Because that's
darn.
When it shut down. You know, oddly, has soft serve is the Blarney Castle. I used to get the Sundays there. But, yeah, I don't know. I wish
they
had some
ice
cream.
They would make their own little baked goods at Major Cool-Off too.
Yeah, they did. Plus, they had that little cool like Miss Pac-Man table arcade, which was fun.
Yeah.
I love the table arcades. Those are cool. Yeah, I really kind of did like Major Cool-Off just as much. Maybe not just as much, but they were close to the corner. The thing about Custer Corner is they have just so many flavors.
They have the high fat content in there.
Yeah, they Custard. Definitely do. And well, now I wish we would have went there. Oh well. Maybe tomorrow, perhaps.
Happens if I stop petting you. Oh no, the hand is not petting you. What shall you do? I wonder how long before I get kicked. He's just looking very sus. Oh. Move that little head. Oh.
Oliver is... never mind.
He's dreadfully cute, but also very bad.
He is.
Very bad as well.
Yeah, I don't know. Major Cool-Off is good. There was a bunch of cool custard places. I don't know if they're as common in other places. I don't remember ever seeing them so much outside of, like, this sort of, like, Rust Belt area.
Hmm.
Maybe they are. Maybe I'm just imagining it. But...
I don't know.
I like the one that we went to in Erie, Pennsylvania with the...
Yeah, I don't like that. They don't have as much high-fat content.
I just like that blue flavor, though.
The Blue Moon flavor?
Yeah, that's good.
I did not like the Blue Moon flavor.
That's okay.
I know you like it.
Maybe I just like the novelty of it, but... I don't know.
Is a novelty, that is true.
But I just enjoy it. Plus, I don't know. It's a very sort of weird location because it's next to a car wash with the same name. It's like a car wash / ice cream store.
There's a car wash there? Oops, I didn't even notice.
Yeah, it's across the street.
Well, when you spill your ice cream in the car, you gotta get
yeah,
it
that's
out.
Probably
car wash.
True. That's a good point.
You rub that tum tum, buddy.
Yeah, I do enjoy a nice. That weird one that used to have like all the crazy flavors, like the hot dog and the gravy, and
that one was in Fredonia.
Yeah,
that one closed.
Oh, I wonder why.
Yeah, like who was ordering it other than like once for
it was someone with an A as well. Like, I don't know. I think it had an A. I think it was an A.
I do like Anderson's custard now that you say that. They're okay.
There's Abbott's, Anderson's, and then I remember they had cows right there too at that ice cream place.
Oh, cool. I do say that.
Yeah.
Is Anderson's local? I don't know.
It is. It is a local chain.
I do.
And then...
they have really good sandwiches. I used to always...
Rochester has Abbott's.
They're not as good.
They used to be, but they just suddenly went downhill and less cream, less fat in there. You need that cream to make it, give it that taste, and theirs got more crystal-y.
Yeah,
it used to be good. Yeah, I don't know. Do other cities have their own ice cream chains? We have more than one. We also have Nick Charlop's, right?
Yeah, that's true. I used to love Antoinette's. We used to have more than one Antoinette's.
Hmm. Interesting.
But, yeah, I don't know. There is... I just wish we had some now.
Now you're just obsessed with the ice cream or the custard. I don't really like ice cream. I like custard.
I do like
custard. Is my thing.
But I mean, you know, it's not like I really. I don't mind one or the other, especially if it's really good, like ice cream. Like I do love Francis.
Yeah, they're good.
I mean,
they have a lot of vegan options and gluten-free options.
I mean, that's true too. I meant to say Ben and Jerry's for actual ice cream, but yeah, I do enjoy Francis. The Ben and Jerry's thing is, it's weird. The reason it has so much like stuff in Ben and Jerry's, I just found it out, is because the guy can't actually taste anything. He can't smell or taste anything, so he just kind of puts all the stuff in there so it feels good in your mouth, which is why Ben and Jerry's has so much stuff in it. Yeah.
What?
Yeah, I just saw this whole thing on it.
Where did you see this? That sounds untrue.
Oh, somebody shared it on Facebook or something. I mean, maybe it's not, but I just remember somebody... It just said, yeah, he, like, one of them can taste it all, but the other one just only can, like, you know, feel the cold and feel all the stuff. But I don't know. Who knows if that's true Facebook stuff, obviously, not always.
Right.
Who knows? The Ben & Jerry's is just cool because they, like... They're so hardcore, like, nice to, like, their employees, and they're so hardcore, like, keep it super, super local. Like, all the cows live, like, right on the land, and they pay all the farmers, like, a lot for it.
I did not know that.
Yeah, they're, like, super, super nice people.
It would be good if people could be nice.
It would be good.
There are not enough nice people.
I love when I went to the Ben & Jerry's actual place, and I like the little, like, actual Ben & Jerry's stands they have around, because they actually have custard outside on top of the regular ice cream, and I just remember being so good.
Oh, that does sound good. The custard, yeah.
Ben & Jerry's factory is one of the coolest places to go to if you can. I thought that was so much fun. I went to there, and then I went to the American Teddy Bear Factory, which was also pretty fun, but Ben & Jerry's...
No.
Had stuff, so I don't know.
No. No. Sorry, he's looking at his foot that, like, he wants to scream and bite it.
That's what he does.
No. Come on, leave it alone. Leave it alone. Leave your foot alone.
But, yeah, I'm trying to look up where that is. Oh, here we go. Here's the team I was thinking of that's the women's team. It's the Rochester Americans. They're the one. And it wasn't football. It was the hockey team, the women's hockey team. The Rochester Americans. They're the one that sponsored Rachel's. That's what I was thinking of.
That's weird.
Yeah.
It's Rachel's Buffalo chain.
Yeah, that is kind of weird. But yeah, that's the one. I was gonna say, I knew it was like a really definitive logo, and it was the Rochester Americans.
Where are you going?
What's up, Chips?
Where are you trying to go, Chip?
Yeah, Rachel's is super tasty. Like, I like their hummus even more than the hummus at Alibaba, to be honest.
Well, you like El Satan's.
El Satan's is my favorite for the hummus. I mean, they're like... I like that a lot. Like, I think they're all good for different things, but I do... Yeah, I don't know. There are as many good places to eat in Buffalo, be they a chain or not.
It's true. We don't have any shortage of good food.
Right, puppies? But, yeah, it's very, very delightful place. I'm trying to think of other, like, good places. There's, like, some non-good places. Well, there's places that are mixed, but, you know. I was just trying to think of places that are, like, less good that are known here, and I could only think of, like, one, and it's not super.
What one?
Just that one where you got that gross waffle.
I got a waffle?
You got that gross gluten-free waffle.
Oh, yeah. I don't think that's... Yeah, it was very sugary. But that happens with a lot of gluten-free foods. They put more sugar in it. So I don't even really usually try and order anything that isn't normally gluten-free. Because a lot of times, you know, too sugary.
I did like the waffles there, but obviously...
Yeah, your food was good. You know. At least it looked good. I mean,
yeah, that was really good. But I don't know. Well, this was a very rambly episode. I'm sorry. But I'm glad I finally realized it was the Rochester Americans. They weren't the only sponsor. It was them with, like, some of the other teams from around here. But, yeah, that was it. It was the women's hockey team.
Give us a call and you can tell us your favorite local food place, because we'd like to know so we can eat there in case we haven't.